Hello guys, in this video we will tell you about the career graph of a marine engineer, their salary and the future prospects of a marine engineer. So before we start, let's assume a situation. A ship is sailing in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean and suddenly its engine stops and cannot be repaired. Then what will happen? It's a scary situation as a ship is hundreds of miles away from the land and no assistance can be sent to the ship for days. That is why to handle this kind of situation, we require highly skilled engineers on ship who can keep the show running in any kind of situation. That is why marine engineers, those who are working on ship, are highly skilled, decorated officers and highly paid. In our previous videos, we have already told you about how you can become a marine engineer. Please subscribe to our channel and watch those videos. They will be very useful to you. So let's see. What is the career graph of a marine engineer and how much salary they get? To become a marine engineer, you should be either 12th pass with PCM or mechanical engineer or a diploma holder. If you are 12th pass, then you have to do BTech in marine engineer, that is a 4-year degree course. If you are a mechanical engineer and you have already done 4-year BTech in mechanical engineering, then you have to do 1-year graduate marine engineer course, that is called GME course. And if you are a diploma holder, then you have to do 2 years diploma marine engineer course, that is DME course. Whatever route you choose, after completion of your course, you will be posted as a junior engineer or trainee marine engineer or engine cadet on the ship. As a junior engineer, your salary will be around $500, that is something around 30,000 rupees. See guys, here I'll tell you the salary and your career graph is totally dependent upon a company. How good company you choose during your sponsorship or during your campus selection. Anyways, so here I would like to tell you that now Indian government has made it mandatory for all the institutes to provide a job to its students. So if you are selected in any institute, then you don't have to worry about your job. It is the responsibility of the institute to provide you a job. Only thing you have to be careful about is that you select a good company so that you get a good salary and at the same time your career also rises nicely. So once you get a job as junior engineer, trainee marine engineer, they are all same ranks, only their names are different. Then your career in merchant navy starts. After working for 6 months on ship as trainee marine engineer, you have to give an exam conducted by Government of India, that is called MEO class 4 exam. This is a exam which is required to be promoted from junior engineer to fourth engineer rank. Without this exam, clearing this exam, you cannot be promoted to the next rank. You have to serve as junior engineer only. So people generally take 6 months to 1 year time to clear this exam, and once you clear this exam, you get a certificate from the Government of India, that is called Certificate of Competency Class 4. And after getting this certificate, you can be promoted to the next rank, that is 4th engineer rank on ship. As 4th engineer, your salary will be approximately $2,000, which is around 1,50,000 Indian rupees per month. After 4th engineer rank, the next rank is the 3rd engineer rank. To be promoted from 4th engineer to 3rd engineer rank, you don't require any exam to pass. It totally depends upon your performance, your report sent by the chief engineer of the ship and the company policies. So if your performance is good and company thinks that you can be promoted to the next rank, your chief engineer recommends you for promotion, then you will be promoted to the next rank. Generally, companies consider those candidates who have served at least 12 months in the rank of 4th engineer. So after that rank, you can be promoted to the 3rd engineer rank, where your salary will be something around $4,000, that is approximately 2,50,000 rupees per month. After 3rd engineer rank, the next rank comes 2nd engineer. 2nd engineer is a senior rank and practically he can be called the boss of the engine room, as everybody working in the engine room, all the other engineers and the crew, they work under 2nd engineer and everybody follows 2nd engineer's instructions in day-to-day business. And 2nd engineer works under the chief engineer, but practically the engine room boss is the 2nd engineer. So to become second engineer, you need to give another exam, that is called MEO class 2 exam. To appear for MEO class 2 exam, you should have worked at least 12 months in the rank of 4th engineer or 3rd engineer or combined. So your total time of work as 4th engineer or 3rd engineer, that should be total 12 months, and after that you can appear for the second engineer exam, that is MEO class 2 exam. Once you clear this exam, you get the certificate of competency of class 2, then you can be promoted to the next rank of the second engineer. So to become second engineer, you should have certificate of competency class 2, and company should be willing to promote you because of your performance. So your performance has to be good, and chief engineer should recommend you for the promotion. After becoming second engineer, your salary becomes huge. You will be getting around $7,000 to $10,000 per month. If you convert this salary to Indian rupees, it comes around 5 lakh rupees to 7 lakh rupees per month. So guys, second engineer is a very important post, because after becoming second engineer, you earn very high salary. At the same time, you become a senior engineer, so your respect, your value in the company increases. So try to reach this rank as soon as possible. That totally depends upon you, how quickly you clear your exams and how good you perform in the company on the ships. Right, so after second engineer rank, there is a chief engineer rank. Chief engineer is the boss of the engine room, or he is the in charge of all the machineries, shipboard machineries, and this is the top rank one can achieve on ship. Chief engineer and captain, they both are of the same rank. They get the same salary, they get the same kind of facility, same kind of treatment. So chief engineer is the top boss and the top rank of an engineer working on the ship. Chief engineer salary is around 7 lakh rupees to 10 lakh rupees per month, depending upon the ship and depending upon the company. But to become a chief engineer, again you have to give an exam, that is called MEO class exam, or after passing this exam you will get certificate of competency class 1. So to give this exam as a second engineer, or after your certificate of competency class 2 exam, you should work at least 18 months on ship, then you are eligible, you become eligible to give class 1 exam. So after working for 18 months, you can give chief engineer exam, that is MEO class 1 exam. And once you clear this exam, and again depending upon your performance and willingness of the company to promote you to the chief engineer rank, you become chief engineer, that is the top boss of the ship. He doesn't involve himself in the day-to-day maintenance of the machineries, because it's a management rank and he has to look after many things related to the company, maker, owner, and so his job is mainly administrative job rather than being a maintenance job. After chief engineer, there are no more promotions, because that is the topmost rank on ship. But after becoming chief engineer, opportunity opens up for office jobs worldwide in the topmost companies, maritime companies like Singapore, Hong Kong, Dubai, and in many countries you can easily get a job as an engineer in their offices of these worldwide well-renowned companies with well-respected and with very high salaries. So guys, you have seen that the marine engineering is not only a highly paid job, but also is a very respected and decorated job, and gives you an opportunity to work on ship as well as in a multinational companies all over the world. So if you are interested to join Merchant Navy as marine engineer, start preparing whatever course you want to do. Guys, be very careful while choosing a company and an institute, because a good company can take your career in a very right direction, and a wrong choice of company and a wrong choice of institute can lead you to a disastrous career. So definitely it's a good job, it's a very highly paid job, but you must choose a right path, right institute, and a good company. As I told you, salary also depends upon company to company, and if a company has only one type of ships, then your career will not rise that much. And if a company has so many variety of ships, it has got tankers, it has got bulk carriers, containers, gas carriers, then you have an opportunity to switch over from one type of ships to another type of ships. So choose a right company from the starting only, choose the right institute. For that, you have to prepare well so that you can get good rank in their entrance exams. And also, information should be very clear to you when you decide to choose Merchant Navy as a career. You should be loaded with the information so that you can go in the right direction. You can choose the right company and right institute. Before I end up, again I tell you that do the course only from the DG Shipping of India approved institutes and no one else.